As a commissioner for digital digital economy and society, it's real important part of my work to listening what are the challenges in front of audiovisual sector and what are the answers then we as a European Commission we can give them. That's why when we talk about audiovisual sector in my work, it's really important first to see how the negotiations who are going on actually with the Parliament and the Council can be finalized as soon as possible. Today there is an emergency. We need to work more quickly and to bring concrete results for the sector. When we talked about the Audiovisual Media Services Directive, it's important the protection of minors. When we talk about copyright, it's important to give to our authors means to negotiate, to protect themselves and to be innovative and to create. And for me, it's one part of my work. Another part, it's the media program, and it's a very challenging time because by the end of this year we will renew the program, and that's why for me it's really important at that moment to listening the different actors in different sectors, what are their ideas. For the moment we know that media program is one of our biggest success. It's a symbol for all of us. It's our value and our values and our principles. It's our linguistic and cultural diversity. But today, that's a challenging time, especially when we talk about the digital transformation. That's why my appeal is let's be more concrete what we can do together with the new program media for the period 2018-2020, and let's do it. The film cinema is the shortest way to touch citizens. When we want to express our emotions, when we want to shape our vision for the society and for the world, that's why for me cinema has a crucial role in this transformation than we live actually. For me, it's really important to bring the culture and the cinema in the heart of our policies. We need to assure more accessibility of the content for citizens. We need to promote the co-productions. When we talk about films, we know that when we have one European film, the distribution is in 4-5 member states. It's not enough. We need to work that the content can be accessible for all citizens. That's why as a European Commission we would like to strengthen these aspects. More co-productions, access to credits and more accent on the distribution of the promotion of our European values and our European principles, and the cinema is the best way to do it. The role of the media is crucial for this European identity that we are so proud, but we need to promote it. And it's crucial for this linguistic diversity. For me, it's really important as a European Commission to continue the support for small producers, for small countries. Because, please, I would like to be very clear. There is no small and big countries. There is no small and big producer when we talk about culture, because it's universal. It's a real treasure for all of us. That's why it's really important to give them a financial support, to assure the connectivity, to assure the distribution, not only in the European countries, but all over the world. And media program is a central instrument for that. We have already enormous success. I would like just to remember that from the beginning of the program as a European Commission, we invest 2.5 billion euros every year. This year, for example, we financing 2,000 projects, film, video games, different pieces of this sector. Now it's really important to be efficient, to be flexible, and to be more strong when we talk about our success stories and when we talk about the unicity of our European culture. I'm strongly convinced of the power of culture against populism. When we talk about culture, we talk about tolerance, we talk about solidarity, and this kind of emotions, of identities, populists are against, and they use them, they instrumentalize them. That's why the culture can be the most powerful instrument against populism.